wind whistling and whipping.
Well,
outside.
It's actually our air conditioner. But
Which you probably have on because it's freezing.
It is cold in here. That's right. Yeah, the winds have been blowing, though. I want to show you something because we always show you photos of the fall colors across New Mexico and also, of course, the weather across New Mexico. But this is an awesome shot. Jay McKinnon from Farmington caught this. Captured this shot of a bald eagle that is along the Animas River in Farmington, and just beautiful shot there. We'd love to see your photos of nature around New Mexico. You can upload them to our ULocal page at KOAT.com. And in the Farmington area, it's quiet right now. Clear skies overhead, a little bit of a breeze continuing in the Farmington area. Chill in the air, and it's going to be a cold one for tonight in Farmington. Not under a freeze warning because you've already had a freeze in Farmington. You're past the freeze date there, but we do have freeze warnings for the Albuquerque Metro down through Socorro, also in the east and northeast, and even areas of the southeast parts of the state. Skies mostly clear across New Mexico, and that's going to allow those temperatures to really drop as we head through the night. Right now in Farmington, it's 56 degrees, 57 in Santa Fe, 60 in Albuquerque, looking at 54 in Roswell. And Hobbs, you are under a freeze warning tonight in the southeastern parts of the state, 48 in Hobbs right now. So a real chill there with a 23-mile-per-hour wind. Yeah, you know it feels cold. Farmington, 21-mile-per-hour wind. Here in Albuquerque, a 16-mile-per-hour breeze, but all of those breezes or winds will be calming down tonight. And it looks like a great day. Of course, we have the Lobo Howl tonight. We've got the Lobo football team taking on the Utah State Aggies at 7 p.m. tomorrow. 59 for the kickoff temperature. Lots of bright skies to start. And then, of course, those temperatures will be coming down as we head through the evening hours. So you'll want several layers if you're heading to the game tomorrow evening. The outlook for rain and snow across New Mexico. You know, this isn't a great outlook. At least the northwestern part of the state and the Four Corners region has equal chances of above normal or normal or maybe even below normal moisture for November. But right now, it looks like much of the state is going to be seeing less than or drier than normal rain and snow for the month of November, and temperatures are forecast for the month of November to be above normal for all parts of New Mexico. Farmington, the Four Corners, not going to feel above normal tonight. Certainly lows in the teens and 20s, a cold night, bundle up, sunshine tomorrow, a really nice weekend with the bright skies out there. Watch for those bald eagles and take pictures if you can. Upload them to our ULocal page. Southwest New Mexico, 36 in Silver City, 68 for a high tomorrow, lots of sunshine, 70 for your Sunday. Southeast New Mexico, as I mentioned, Hobbs, a freeze warning tonight, 31 the overnight low, 65 there for a high tomorrow, 69 in Carlsbad. Temperatures warm up for your Sunday. And into the northeast, a cold night from Red River, Raton, Las Vegas, into Taos. And yeah, Santa Rosa, you have a freeze warning, 31 degrees for tonight. Bundle up, it's going to be a cold one. Protect the pets, the plants, the tender vegetation, as we always say. 25 in Santa Fe tonight, 58 in Santa Fe tomorrow, 60 on the plaza in Santa Fe on Sunday. And Bernalillo to Blinn, we had that freeze warning in effect, Rio Rancho 2. Take time to protect the tender plants, the vegetation, and also, of course, as we say, the pets. 35 for the heights, 29 in the valleys. 7-day planner shows we'll see those temperatures kind of up and down the next few days and then warming up for the middle part of next week. But, yeah, you know, the outlook for November, we'd like to see it saying, you know, lots of moisture on the way because we still need that moisture. The monsoon was good, but we still need more. And coming up at 10 o'clock, I'll have a look through the rest of the upcoming winter how things are going to look.
So, okay, thanks, Byron. Yeah. Still ahead.